Hi everyone, welcome to the 8th video for the quantitative methods course, and in this video I'll be talking about how to do mediation in linear models. Now mediation happens when there's an effect of x on y which actually runs through a third variable which we call the mediator. And in Stata we're going to use the SEM command for this, which is called structural equations modeling, which is quite a general command which can do a lot of things. And it's really nice for using mediation. So we'll first load up the data, and let me then show you how an SEM model typically looks, at least a mediation model. Now you can use this by navigating to statistics and then SEM model building estimation, and you'll get into this model builder. And there we can basically just draw the model that we want to estimate. So here we will have the effect of a variable, which will be cash, on the mediator, which will be acquisitions, and then on the outcome variable, gross profits. So this is the mediated effect. And then you also need to include the direct effect from cash, which is called CH, on gross profits, GP. And the mediator was AQC, which is acquisitions. So this model here is essentially your what they call simple mediation model. Now, if we want to include some control variables, we can do this by simply adding one variable and including that both in the equation for acquisition and for GP. But actually, we're not doing that for this example. Now we can estimate this model with various options. I won't belabor those too much. We'll just estimate the simple model for now without robust standard errors, just to show you what comes out. This is what comes out. And what you see on the right there is how the SEM command is structured. So you would typically type SEM, and then between parentheses are the different lines that we drew, so the arrows. So as you can see here, we drew a line from CH to AQC. So this here means CH has an effect on acquisitions. We drew a line from acquisitions to GP, and we drew a line from cash to GP. You can rewrite this by organizing them into the two equations that we have, and as we will also have seen in class. Here there's one equation, cash to acquisition, so that's what they call the first step. And the second step includes the effects of both cash and acquisitions on GP. And this will be the same as this command above here, just a bit more simplified. Now SEM, you always have to add the option no caps latent if you want to just do the mediation model that we'll be doing. If you don't include these options, data will be a bit confused sometimes because it's case sensitive, and with capital letters, it will read it as what they call a latent variable. And that's not something that we are interested in. And furthermore, as always, we'll do the robust standard errors with the option VCE robust. So let me just run this model, which will have the correct standard errors, and then you get the output. Now this here is the direct effect of cash on acquisitions. This here is the direct effect of cash on gross profits. So that's the direct effect of the independent variable on the outcome variable. And this here is the direct effect of acquisitions on gross profits. Now, as we will have discussed in class, you can calculate the indirect effect of cash on gross profits by multiplying this one times this one. And adding those two up, the direct effect of cash and the indirect effect, you'll get the total effect. Thankfully, Stata has a nice command after running SEM, which will just calculate things for you. That's estat t effects. So if you run this, you actually get all these pieces of info. As I just mentioned, these are all the direct effects. It's exactly the same as the coefficients that we've seen. And then the indirect effect is this, which is actually this one times this one. And then finally, you have the total effects. The total effects of acquisitions on GP is just the direct effect because there's only that one. And then you see here for cash, it's the sum of the indirect effect and the direct effect. We can also just see how much of that indirect effect how much of the total effect is the indirect effect. We can do this with just calculating. So we can divide the indirect effect here on the right by the total effect, multiplying it by 100 to get percentages. And we can see that the indirect effect is actually pretty small. It's 1.11% of the total effect runs via the mediator. So that's really quite small. And likewise, you can do this for the direct effect, and that will be 98.89%. So much more of the effect of cash on gross profits is direct rather than mediated. And indeed, we can also see that this indirect effect does not appear to be statistically significant. So had we hypothesized that there is a mediation, partial or full mediation, it doesn't matter here, there would be no evidence that either one applies because it's a highly insignificant indirect effect. So there's no mediation in this example. Now, as we will have discussed in class, this p-value here for the indirect effect is actually not correct. The standard assumptions that you need to get this p-value actually don't hold when you calculate an indirect effect. So if you want to do this for your thesis later, you're going to have to bootstrap this indirect effect, which is something we'll talk a bit more about in class. But you can use the bootstrap command for this. And we're going to say we want to bootstrap the indirect effect. Let's call it AB, but this can be anything we want. And as mentioned, the indirect effect is the coefficient of cash in the equation for acquisitions times the coefficient for acquisitions in the equation for GP. And that's what you see here. So this first piece here between square brackets is which equation are we looking at? So this is the acquisitions equation, lower dash B, and then square parentheses means this coefficient in this equation. So the cash coefficient in the acquisitions equation times the acquisitions coefficient in the GP equation. So this thing between parentheses is what we want to bootstrap. So this is the indirect effect. And we want to then add some options. Let's say we want to bootstrap it 10 times. Typically, you'd want to do this 100, if not 1000 or more times. Just for the sake of time, I'll do 10. You always have to specify what they call a seed. This will make sure that every time you run it, you will get the same results. So I would always just do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 or something like that. But just make sure to always use the same one. And then you have a colon, and then you type the command that this statistic will come from. So this is the SEM command that we have above here. So you do need to include this here, else Stata wouldn't know what these equations and coefficients refer to. Now, if we run this, you're going to see it will repeat 10 times, and it's going to estimate this SEM command on a subsample of this full sample and repeat that 10 times to calculate this statistic 10 times. So you see, this is the calculated indirect effect. This is the bootstrap standard error, and this is the p-value. You already see it's slightly different from the p-value that we had before. There's another step required, as discussed in class. You need to get what they call not the normal-based confidence intervals, because that assumption doesn't hold, but the bias-corrected confidence interval. So after running this bootstrap, you do estat bootstrap with the option percentile BC. This will generate the bias-corrected confidence interval for you. So this is what we are ultimately interested in. You see there's no longer a p-value because that doesn't apply anymore. But if we want to now report whether we have mediation or not, we would report this. So this is the indirect effect. And then we would check whether this confidence interval, the 95% confidence interval, overlaps with zero or not. Here it does, which implies that we cannot say that this indirect effect is different from zero. So in other words, there is no mediation. If this whole both lower and higher level of the confidence interval are either negative, so both negative or both positive, then we can conclude that there is mediation. But here there's not, similar to what we found in kind of the naive approach that we had. If we want, we can likewise calculate the total effect in this way. So this here, what we had before is the indirect effect, and now adding the direct effect of cash in the GP equation, and the rest of the command is the same, and we can again get the bootstrapped results. And that's all you need to know for running mediation in a quantitatively sound way. To summarize, you need to estimate first an SEM model to get the coefficients. You can interpret that a little bit, but I would recommend then bootstrapping it, getting the bias-corrected intervals for the indirect effect, and especially to then interpret that as we just did. And then you can conclude really if there's mediation or not. Thanks for watching, and in the next video, we'll actually move towards nonlinear effects in linear models. Hope to see you there.